F-16, officially the Fighting Falcon, though affectionately called the Viper by its pilots, marked its 50th anniversary, remaining the world's most widely used fighter jets. With approximately 3,100 aircraft still in service across 25 nations, its enduring legacy is unmatched. From its very first flight, the F-16's exceptional versatility set it apart. Far more than just a fighter, it was designed to evolve into a true multi-role powerhouse, capable of excelling in diverse missions across air-to-air combat, ground attack, and reconnaissance. And with the latest upgrade, it became more lethal than ever. Did you know that the F-16 was intentionally designed with aerodynamic instability? Even more impressive, its groundbreaking avionics paved the way for the development of advanced fighters like the F-22 Raptor and F-35 Lightning II. Beyond its role as a game-changer in military aviation, the F-16 also holds an outstanding combat record. Its success was evident in 1982 during the Lebanon War, when Israeli F-16 pilots downed dozens of Syrian MiG-21s and MiG-23s in just 2 days. Since then, the Viper has shot down various types of Soviet aircraft and annihilated many air defense sites with its AGM-88 HARM missiles. Ukraine received its first F-16 fighter jets in early August 2024, marking a significant enhancement to its air defense capabilities. The development of the F-16 Fighting Falcon is a tale of innovation, adaptability, and the pursuit of superior combat performance, making it one of the most iconic and widely used fighter aircraft in history. The F-16's journey began in the late 1960s and early 1970s during the Vietnam War, a period that exposed flaws in the US Air Force's strategy of relying solely on heavy, complex fighter jets like the F-4 Phantom II. The conflict underscored the need for a highly maneuverable, lightweight fighter that could dominate in dogfights. This realization led to the creation of the Lightweight Fighter, or LWF, program, championed by a group of forward-thinking engineers and analysts known as the Lightweight Fighter Mafia. The LWF program emphasized a back-to-basics approach to fighter design, prioritizing agility, cost efficiency, and pilot-centric features over sheer size and firepower. In 1972, General Dynamics and Northrop were selected to produce prototypes for a competitive fly-off, the YF-16 and the YF-17. The YF-16 prototype first took to the skies on January 20, 1974, marking the beginning of a new era in fighter aviation. The aircraft immediately impressed with its performance, showcasing its advanced aerodynamics, lightweight frame, and revolutionary fly-by-wire flight control system, which allowed for unmatched maneuverability. In 1975, after rigorous testing, the US Air Force declared the YF-16 the winner over the YF-17 due to its superior speed, range, and cost-effectiveness. The design was particularly praised for its relaxed static stability feature, which increased maneuverability by allowing the aircraft to remain aerodynamically unstable, controlled entirely by the fly-by-wire system. What is interesting is that the F-16 was designed to be aerodynamically unstable. This feature is also known as relaxed static stability, or RSS. In this scenario, the aircraft naturally wants to depart from a controlled flight and requires constant input from the pilot or a flight control system to maintain stability. However, this instability provides several advantages, such as allowing the F-16 to make tighter turns and faster rolls at higher speeds compared to a stable aircraft, as well as reducing drag and increasing fuel efficiency by eliminating the need for large vertical stabilizers and other stability-enhancing features. The downside is that this engineering approach makes the F-16 inherently difficult to control without assistance. This is where fly-by-wire comes in. The F-16's most innovative design feature is its fly-by-wire control system, which was the first on any fighter aircraft. This system allows for precise and responsive handling and enhances the aircraft's maneuverability. In a normal plane, the pilot moves a control wheel or stick connected to the plane's elevator, ailerons, and rudder. But in the F-16, a computer moves the control surfaces in response to electronic input from the pilot's control stick. This innovation allowed the F-16 to be designed with negative stability, which makes it more maneuverable, as the F-16's quadruple redundant fly-by-wire computer automatically makes constant split-second corrections to keep the plane stable. The maneuverability of the F-16 is also aided by aerodynamics. The F-16 wing experiences less vortex lift, which prevents it from stalling at the high angles of attack needed for difficult maneuvers. The F-16's heart and soul lie in its engines, delivering the raw power that makes this fighter a legend in the skies. Whether roaring with the Pratt & Whitney F-100 or the General Electric F-110, the F-16's engine choices define its unparalleled performance. Early models relied on the reliable F-100, while later variants embraced the higher thrust F-110, propelling the aircraft to speeds over Mach 2. Both engines brought groundbreaking innovations, from digital electronic engine control for razor-sharp responsiveness to thrust levels exceeding 29,000 pounds, enabling the F-16 to outmaneuver opponents in high-G dogfights. The F-16 is capable of traveling at twice the speed of sound, or approximately 1,500 miles per hour. It can fly up to a height of 50,000 feet and has a maximum range of about 2,000 miles. The aircraft's combat radius is approximately 340 miles. The F-16's armament includes a 20mm M61A1 Vulcan cannon with 511 rounds of ammunition. The cannon can fire up to 6,000 rounds per minute and has a range of approximately 40,000 feet. The F-16 can carry a wide range of air-to-air and air-to-surface missiles, including the AIM-120 Advanced Medium-Range Air-to-Air Missile, or AMRAM, the AIM-9 Sidewinder, and AGM-88 High-Speed Anti-Radiation Missile, or HARM, and the AGM-65 Maverick, among others. It can also carry a variety of bombs, including laser-guided bombs. The AGM-88 HARM missile is a very powerful weapon system that makes F-16 a fearsome opponent. Let's see how this missile operates. The AGM-88 HARM is an air-to-surface tactical missile designed to seek and destroy enemy radar-equipped air defense systems. Once an enemy radar emission is detected, the HARM's onboard guidance system calculates the location of the radar emitter and plots a course to that target. The missile is then directed to fly toward the radar site, following the source of the radar emissions. The missile's home-on radar capability is particularly effective against enemy radar sites that are active, meaning they are emitting radar signals. In the context of said and dead missions, the HARM missile is typically fired in the general direction of known or suspected enemy air defense positions. Once in flight, the missile will home in on any detected radar emissions, destroying the source and thus neutralizing the threat. The HARM can engage its targets in two primary modes, preemptive and reactive. In the preemptive mode, the HARM is used to strike at known enemy air defense sites, typically before a major air operation. In the reactive mode, the missile is used to counter enemy air defenses that become active during a mission, responding to the threat in real time. If the radar site is not emitting, the missile's passive radar seeker will not be able to detect and engage it. However, modern air defense systems often need to keep their radars active to effectively engage incoming aircraft, making them vulnerable to HARM strikes. In F-16 development, a block refers to a specific production series, with each introducing upgrades to enhance the aircraft's capabilities. The latest Block 7072, or F-16V, incorporates cutting-edge technology, making the F-16 a multi-role powerhouse across generations. The F-16V Viper features a cutting-edge glass cockpit equipped with an upgraded mission computer and advanced avionics. These include color multifunction displays, a large high-resolution center pedestal display, a helmet-mounted queuing system, and a high-speed, high-volume data bus. The center pedestal display, or CPD, enhances crew situational awareness by processing and displaying real-time flight safety data. The Viper is outfitted with a programmable display generator, a Link 16 Theta data link, identification friend or foe, or IFF systems, and HF, UHF, VHF radio communications. Its single high-performance modular mission computer replaces the original three, delivering superior computer power to support avionics and weapon systems. This upgrade enhances situational awareness, air-to-air strike capabilities, precise targeting, and information processing. The aircraft's gigabit Ethernet-based architecture allows seamless control of electronic warfare, or EW, displays and avionics systems. Additional features include precision GPS navigation and an automated ground collision avoidance system, which alerts the pilot of impending ground collisions and autonomously maneuvers the aircraft to prevent crashes if the pilot does not respond to warnings. The F-16V's APG-83 AESA radar provides advanced all-weather targeting capabilities, enabling high-resolution detection and imaging of ground targets. Its phased array design supports simultaneous air-to-air and air-to-surface operations. Equipped with the Sniper Advanced Targeting Pod, or ATP, the Viper excels in both air-to-surface and air-to-air targeting. This system facilitates the deployment of laser-guided and GPS-guided weapons against multiple stationary or moving targets. The aircraft can also be outfitted with FLIR laser systems, as well as reconnaissance and navigation pods. Together, the Sniper ATP and Legion ES Infrared Search and Track, or IRST, system significantly enhance the pilot's situational awareness and improve survivability in combat. This concludes our episode that provides a glimpse into the F-16 Viper. So what do you think about this fascinating aircraft? What other pieces of military hardware would you like us to cover in our future episodes? Also, if you are lucky enough to see these aircraft up close, or better yet, fly one, please comment. Remember to hit the subscribe button and ring that bell to stay updated with our latest content. And while you're here, why not check out another one of our exciting videos? Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.